The WA coroner is about to begin a week of public hearings on Christmas Island as he continues his wide-ranging investigation into the asylum seeker shipwreck, which claimed 50 lives. Christmas Island residents who tried in vain to rescue victims of the boat tragedy are expecting to be among those giving evidence to the coronial inquest.
It's 7 months since the doomed asylum boat carrying more than 90 people was smashed against the cliffs on Christmas Island. In the months since, people here have not only had to carry the memories of that tragedy, but endure riots at the island's detention centre and uncertainty over the federal government's so-called Malaysia solution. But as the asylum seekers targeted for offshore processing remain behind the wire, Christmas Island residents will be filing into the recreation centre just metres away, where the coroner will hear evidence from those who witnessed the tragedy.
In statements already provided to the coroner, residents have told how they were woken by yelling and screaming as the boat lurched towards the cliffs here at Rocky Point. And after throwing life jackets and ropes into the sea, they could do little more than direct the customs and navy crews to those people still alive and still struggling in the water.
The coroner's investigation has focused on whether the customs and navy response to the emergency was adequate and whether more could and should have been done to ensure the doomed boat was detected earlier. He's also scrutinised the standard of rescue boats based on the island, none of which could operate in the heavy seas on the day of the tragedy. Those issues are expected to come under scrutiny again at this week's hearings. Andrew O'Connor, ABC News, Christmas Island.